Warning, this experiment uses highly flammable substances and strong oxidizers. Work outside in a fume hood and fire safety protocols must be in place. Greetings fellow nerds. I've always wanted to redo the test tube thunderstorm experiment on a bigger scale. It also includes sound, as this is one of those rare experiments where audio is part of the experience. Since now is as good a time as any, let's get started. To perform the experiment, we first get about 80 milliliters or so of ethanol in a 250 milliliter beaker. Now we put a glass funnel all the way to the bottom and carefully pour in 98% sulfuric acid until we form a layer about half a centimeter or a quarter inch. We need the layer to remain distinct from the ethanol, and the funnel helps to prevent the layer of sulfuric acid from mixing. Now for the fun part, get some potassium permanganate, about half a gram or so, and carefully sprinkle it in. It'll take a moment to get started, but eventually you'll hear popping sounds and see tiny flashes of light. What's happening is the sinking potassium permanganate crystals react with the sulfuric acid to produce manganese heptoxide, an extremely powerful and reactive oxidant. The blob of manganese heptoxide floats back up and reacts with the flammable ethanol and makes a tiny little explosion. It'll go on for a few minutes and usually stops when it runs out of permanganate, or if the layer is mixed so much that the sulfuric acid is no longer concentrated enough to produce manganese heptoxide. For safety, to quench the reaction when you're done, take the whole beaker and dilute it into several times its volume of water. Be careful though, as it can still catch fire as you're pouring it in. Anyway, let's try that again. Be very careful when sprinkling in the potassium permanganate, because if you accidentally dump it in, it will break the layers and cause them to self-stir. At that point, the mixture can no longer make the thunderstorm. So start with small amounts and go slowly until you get some practice. But eventually, with a steady hand, we can add a fair amount of potassium permanganate and really get it going. And that is the thunderstorm in a beaker we were looking for. This reaction will work with any flammable liquids, including acetone, methyl ethyl ketone, and butyl acetate, and I'm sure many more. But since ethanol is the easiest to get, I recommend going with that. Methanol does work, but a bit too well. It can be very temperamental and volatile, sometimes self-boiling if the layers start mixing. So for safety reasons, I recommend against it. One last run before I go. YouTube will probably demonetize this video, but no, well, that's why I ask for your Patreon support, and I'm having too much fun to stop. Now I gave the fire safety warning at the beginning of the video, but I want to emphasize again that this reaction is dangerous. It can occasionally ignite itself, and in fact that did occur in a few of my runs. Although granted, many would say this is a feature and not a drawback. But I'll say it again, fire safety protocols must be in place. And that was a redo of the test tube Thunderstorm, but this time as a Thunderstorm in a beaker. Thanks for watching, please subscribe, like, and comment. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.